Ken Spriggs here with part 7 of my discovery build, and a little bit of a delay between the last build and this one here. As I told you in my last video, I was dealing with a cold and some bronchitis, so I was feeling pretty miserable, so that hampered me a bit. 2 weeks ago, I also went away to Pennsylvania to visit my family and attend a little event there as well. So that also took some of the time, but I've been working on the pod bay. And as you can see from the opening images on this video, focusing on the iconic hallway, the black and white hallway that you see Dave Bowman walking through. We don't really have a name for it. I just call it the storage compartment. We see him coming out of it one time with the AE-35 unit for the antenna array to replace it. And we also see it in 2010, the year we make contact. But in that movie, it's more just for iconic reasons. It's not there for any other purpose. And in 2010, for some strange reason, they show a doorway at the end of it, and they come through it, and it somehow leads up to the cockpit. It's kind of strange. But in the stills from the original movie, we don't see any doorway at the end. It's just a bunch of piping and some cargo modules, things like that. So I started working on that, and that's going to be a separate sub-assembly. So the pod bay is going to take a lot longer to complete than the cockpit. The cockpit was just a couple of sections and a little bit of adding on to the photo etch. The pod bay is going to have several different add-ons and sub-assemblies and things of that nature. So I really want it to look good. You're going to see it really well from the pod doors that I'm going to have open, and I'll show you that here in a minute. But let me show you what I've got accomplished, and I think it's really going to be pretty cool. All right. All right, so as you saw from the previous video clip and the still, I'm starting to work on the iconic maintenance corridor, the octagonal tube that Dave Bowman walks through, I believe just one time during the movie. We're led to believe it's kind of a maintenance storage or something, because he goes in there and we see him coming out of there with the AE-35 unit that he then leaves the ship with to replace with the antenna array. We see it one more time in 2010, but it's not really showing any purpose there. So we kind of get the idea that all the little compartments on the sides, they seem to have labels on them, and you would imagine they would open up and there's a lot of stored parts for the ship, that sort of thing. So, but what I've kind of figured out is that the corridors can be broken down basically to just a series of squares, square panels through it, separated by a light panel for each of these sections. And then you have this, this black stripe that goes between them, which I'm not really sure what that's for, but it looks like on the floor at least they represent like a foot pad kind of thing. I think he was just going for more of an aesthetic that he's had throughout the film with the black and white contrast. He has a lot of shots where we're looking down some tube or something of that nature. But it certainly looks cool and it's very iconic for the ship. So I want to make my own and put it behind the photo etch so you can see it and have it lit up. So basically, I'm trying to make the little squares and put them onto a strip and do one strip at a time with a section in between for the clear part to light it. So what I did was I came up with an idea and started primarily with a piece of strip styrene, as you can see right here. And the one I'm using is from Evergreen, and it's 0.040 times 0.250. And I have several pieces in here, so it's pretty much the right thickness, or the width, I mean. The way I came up with it is I traced a square from the photo etch around the door panel to see the size that I'm working with, and then I figured out how wide these would have to be, so that if I had one at the top, one at the bottom, one at each side, and then angled them on each of the corners, How big would it have to be? I started with a smaller piece. Sorry about that. I started with a smaller piece, as you can see from the glue marks on here, and it didn't work out. Once I got it all on there, it didn't fill the entire square, so it wasn't the right size. So I got a bigger piece and just kind of measured along it, and that's going to do what I needed to do, and it's going to go around the edges. So then the next thing I did was I designed a little simple template in order to be able to cut out a square. So going with the idea that to make this square it would have to be as long as it is wide, I just simply made this so that when I put this over top and measured it off, I'm going to get a square piece. And I can just keep replicating it. So I just put it on there and I use a mechanical pencil to just draw a line and make a square out of it, like that. And then I cut it out and sand it smooth and end up with a square. And at that point then, I'm using a piece of clear sheet styrene, just very thin, enough to make it stable, but I wanted it to be clear. So I cut out a strip that's the same length and width that I want it to be. And then what I do is, as I cut each square out, I glue it down onto the plastic, and then once it starts to dry, I just use a piece of this little rectangular styrene and stick it between it and glue another piece and press them together without getting glue on this. So I just space it through. And in the end, this is the piece that I ended up with right here. And you can see that just spaces right in between like that. Well, except it's flat. There you go. All right. So I just put a piece on, let it dry, put this between it, glue another one, let it dry, remove the spacer, do the third one, and so on. And then what I figured out was, for the space inside of the ship, behind the photo etch, I really can't get a very long piece, so the most I could come up with was 3.5. And pretty much what I'm going to do is the half piece is going to be glued towards the front, so you're not really going to see it because it's going to be kind of hidden behind the wall. You're just going to see this image right here, like that. Okay, and then to get those black stripes on there, I used a thin self-adhesive striping roll here, basically used for like racing cars and things like that. And I just kind of eyeballed it till I got the right thickness. And I take a piece off, stretch it between it, and then I just use an X-Acto knife to trim the pieces. And so I just have littler pieces inside, and they're kind of straight along there. So, all right. So that's kind of the way it's gonna work out for me. I know it's kind of hard to see the image now, but let me get a few more of these made up, and then we'll take a look and see how that looks. All right. And then I've also begun to detail one of them, and it came out really nice using some very, very thin styrene and some more of the stripping. But that's kind of the general idea that you're going to see. If you look at it from an angle, you're going to see like a progression of black lines going across or from front to back. And then there's some slight detail on there. You see like the triangular ray sections and then the little black squares on there. And what I did is I'm using a very thin square rod. It's 0.010. You can see it's really thin. That's this little piece right here. Can't even get a good focus on it. There we go. Okay, so super tiny. And that's the nice thing about this styrene stripping in all different sizes and square and round and things like that. They come in real handy to scratch build. So what I've done is just like dab a little bit on some glue, stick it in place until it dries. I'm just using some super glue, and then just snipping it off until I have the sections. And then for the little black squares, I use the same black stripping here, but it's a little thick, so I stuck it on a piece of styrene. And I use an X-Acto knife to first split it in two. I just cut a little bit at a time and split it in two. And then I cut off the end, and it gives me two little squares, as you can see right there. There's two ready to go. Very delicate, for sure. I was going to use something else, maybe like some decals, but I don't think I have enough. Since I'm going to have 8 of these, and at 3 main squares, that's 24, plus a half. So that's quite a bit that I would need. And there's 3 on each square. So 3 times 24 is about, what, 72? That'd be a lot of decals. I don't think I would have that many in any kind of a set. But this works fine. It's a little tricky. Then I just use the tip of the X-Acto knife to kind of poke one of them and then just position it and move it around until I get it in the right spot. And then I use some Tamiya Extra Thin cement dabbed on top of them to hold them in place so they don't move around. And I may yet still put a flat coat on this because the stripping is glossy. We'll see when I get it all together. But that's a completed wall section right there. And I will have 8 of these, and of course they'll be angled and form an octagonal shape. And then you'll see when I start to get the other ones. Right now it's a little bit easy to start seeing the pattern that you see in the movie, but once I get 8 of them, it's going to come together a lot more. And then in those spots in between where the lights are going to be, I'm playing with an idea of using a material called vellum. It's a paper, basically, but it's translucent. So it's kind of easy to work with. You can buy it at a hobby shop. I get it at Hobby Lobby. But you just cut it with the scissors, and it's translucent, and it diffuses the light. So that's nice to use. I've used this for different applications, so... but the holes are so thin and tiny, I'm going to have to come up with some method. What I'm thinking of doing is maybe doing gluing 3 of these together and then cutting out a strip and have it just go between all 3. I'll just bend it and it'll just curve and go through all 3. And then do that 3 times for each of these rows right here. So, but we'll see. I'm still working on that. I was kind of looking for some clear stock, but they don't really sell it as far as like some clear stripping. If I can get this in a clear, that would be perfect. I could just stick it between. But we'll see. We'll get something worked out when I get that going. So I've also begun cutting out and pretty much finished most of the doorway. As you can see. Give you a profile. There we go. Okay, and then what I'll probably do is that the edges are a little rough, so right along the edge I'll probably put some of the thin stripping around there to form my doorway, because it's padded anyway, so I'll build that up a bit. But that's kind of ready to go, so then I can glue the maintenance corridor in the back of it, and it'll cover that entire door. All right, so making some great progress on this. I really like how this is turning out, and I think in the end I'm going to get that really iconic shot that you get from the movie of the doorway, and then work on some lighting for it so I can get it to light up the way it's supposed to look in the movie. So, okay, great. Let me work some more on this, and I'll get the rest of these done, and we'll start putting this together. All right, so I was working some more on completing some of these wall sections. And I started thinking about the lighting and how I was going to get that to shine through correctly, since there's a big gap between these pieces and I want that light to diffuse properly. So I played with a few ideas. You can see on this one that I have some holes drilled through it
I used the pin vise to do that, and I put some fiber optics through it, and I bloomed them. Let me show you that. Got the focus there. Okay, well, that's there we go. And I bloomed the end of it, and it's a pretty thick fiber optic. So I put two pieces through, and even put some of the thin paper that I was showing you, and I just couldn't get it to show an even light. It just kept coming through as two distinct little dots of light, which I don't really want it to look like. The problem is this is just such a thin little structure, it's hard to really diffuse that light very much. So I tried a few tests. Here's another one with some fiber optic through it. And I used some 5-minute epoxy, and I filled that gap in and smoothed it out, hoping that would diffuse the light better. Put some of that vellum on it, like I said, still seeing those little dots, and it didn't really look right. So I tried another test where I wanted to put some solid clear styrene through it, but I didn't have a thick enough piece. So I ended up gluing two thinner pieces together. And you can still see like the line between them. It's hard to get that to have a smooth finish. So it's a little closer to what I'm looking for, as you can see there. But I need something thicker that's going to fill that gap normally. But they don't really sell it in the right thickness. What I need is basically about a millimeter and a half. And I'm just going by, you know, what I ended up creating with these ones here, and that looks about right. But the only styrene sheeting I could find, the thickest I could find from like Evergreen or Plastruct, was 0.030 inches, which roughly comes out to close to a millimeter. So I need somewhere between like a millimeter and a half and 2 millimeters in order to fill that gap. So really hard to find that though, even with plexiglass. So I used my imagination and I scoured the internet, and my favorite place, Hobby Lobby, I ended up finding something that is used for another purpose but works for my purposes, and that's a piece of plastic safety glass, pretty much plexiglass, that I got. It's made for a picture frame, and they come in different sizes. This one's 8 by 10 inches. But it's 1.4 millimeters, which is pretty much perfect with what I need. And it was only $3.99, but I used my 40% discount from Hobby Lobby, which I love. So it only cost me two something. And this is what it looks like. So it's just slightly thinner than what that gap is there. But it's a nice, easily workable piece of plexiglass. So I can cut that into small pieces, and I was using a couple of things. I got a little plexiglass cutter here. It's a little tricky to try to use, but it works fairly well. Or my pull saw, that works a little better, where I just cut out a strip and then I just cut off little tiny pieces and glue it next to the styrene. So here's a piece that I made using that. And you can see that it has a if you can see, yeah, the plastic is flush. There's no gap anymore. Nice light diffusion, no lines, no defects between it. Really nice. And I can smooth out the top of it so it's flush with the surface that you're gonna see. And the back's a little bit bumpy and a little sticking out, but that's not a problem. It actually works in my favor because it catches the light when you shine it from behind it. So, all right, so that's kind of where I'm going to go with these. And I use the same pattern that I did before in the other ones to put the black stripes and dots and things like that. Now it's just a little bit thinner. And I only made three sections because I figured out that I'm really not going to be able to do 3.5 for the whole back. So three is going to be plenty. But they're just a little bit, that clear between is just a little bit smaller. So by the time you get out to the third one, they're off. So
But what I'm going to do is I want to still use these three that I put all the work into. So I'm just going to take my
photo at snips and just cut that plastic in between them, or just take the plastic off the back entirely, and then
use the individual squares and just do the same thing. Use the plastic plexiglass and put it between them so I make them the same size, and then discard that little one on the end so I can make them the right way. All right, so that's coming along well. Let me go ahead and try to put these together and show you what they're going to look like, even though I'm going to end up adapting these. Okay.
All right, there you go. So I just put some tape on the back to hold these together in place and kind of give you an idea of how that's going to look. So that's looking pretty sweet. And as you can see, when you look at it from this angle, you're going to see the black lines separating. Once I get those openings, and that's what I was talking about, those openings right now, you can tell that they are inset. I want them to be flush, and that's what I'll end up with. You're not going to see the thickness of these walls because it's going to be against the photo etch on the back, so you're not going to see it. You're just going to see the interior. And this is a little bigger than the actual doorway, so you're not going to see the whole thing sticking through. So, all right, let me see if I can hold that back behind the photo etch and kind of get an idea of that as well. All right, so I kind of fashioned it up. It's not quite perfect, as you can see. There's a big gap between the panels, but I have it kind of angled the way it's going to look in there, and kind of give you an idea from this side of it. And obviously it doesn't really match up well with the brass, but that kind of gives you an idea of how that's going to look. So that's coming together pretty cool. You're going to see quite a bit of that, as you can see, and they'll be down even further. They'll be closer and more compact. And I'll have a floor and a ceiling, of course, on the other side. But that's coming together nicely. So when you look through there, you're going to see that little iconic hallway. So, all right, fantastic.
All right, here are the finished pieces that I have my final design, where I use the
thin plexiglass in between. And I just have the three sections. And I cut apart the ones that I made originally and took out that gap, the plastic on the back of it, and put the clear in between it. And so I'm starting to glue them onto a sheet of styrene here. And this will be the back wall. And then they'll be coming out this way. And I'll put some detail on the back wall too. And I also took some thin round stock and I put it on the sides of it to
give a solid point for these to connect, and also to put a gap between the lit sections because they are distinct. There is a line between them so that I can start
separating the sections. So let me go ahead and get those glued together and see how that's gonna start turning out here. I still have four more to do, but I wanna get these four together and kind of position it and see how it's gonna look.
All right, so it's really starting to come together. I put a lot of detail on the back of that. I tried to look at the images from the movie. You don't really see it, but there are some stills showing him facing the camera coming through the tunnel. And on the back, you can see some different piping and vertical lines and some little rounded parts like I did right there. And for that little rounded piece, I just used the end of a piece of sprue and glued a piece of styrene onto it. And then different tubing, of course. Some of it goes through the back of the wall. I just drilled a hole through and poked it through, bent the tube a bit, and glued it in place. So, all right, so looking really good. As you can see, that light comes through really nicely. And you get that look of the lines going away from you, and then you have the cross cuts of the lights coming through. So that's looking pretty sweet. And this is actually going to be that end of it. Some of these, since I had to cut them up and glue them back together, didn't turn out as straight as I wanted. So the rest of them, I want them to be the nicest ones, because you're going to see that end of it. It's just the way it's angled. So, all right.
And here are the other four wall sections that I've put together, the basic structure, without any of the black detail striping or the styrene on it. This method turned out really well. I really got it honed in. If I hadn't already made those, and they're good enough for the one side, I would redo those again, but not bad at all. It took me a few hours of doing the little pieces of styrene with the thin plexiglass in between to get that nice light effect. All right, so I have all four of those done. So all I have to do now is get the black striping on and a little bit of styrene detail, and I'll be ready to get this whole thing glued together. All right. Okay, and there is the finished maintenance corridor with all eight sides to it. Show you how that looks with the light shining through there. You can see all eight sides of it. Those lights are going to shine through. I put a couple of decals on that back wall. You can see a little yellow square in the middle, and then those little triangles on the circles there. So that's looking kind of cool. Alright, and it's a nice solid unit. So for lighting purposes, I'm going to use some black electrical tape, and I'm just going to cut strips and just tape it around these sides, other than these little light parts, like this part, and this part, three of them. So that'll mask the entire thing, even between the joints, and then I'll just have light coming through those little strips the way I want it to be, and lighting up the whole thing. And then I'm going to come up with some means of putting some lights around it to do that. Probably just put like a circuit or a light box around it, put some lights in it, so we'll see. But that's turned out fantastic. I'm really pleased with that. So let me go ahead and get that into the back of the photo etch, and I'll show you how that's going to look. All right, so I have it kind of rigged up there on the back of it, just taped on the sides against there, and I don't have any lights around it, but I can shine some light through it. You can kind of see how that's going to look. It's looking pretty awesome, and all those little light panels will be lit up, and the rest of it will be darkened, so it won't light up. But there's the back of it. Not really going to see the other side of it from the angles that you're going to be looking through the pod bay, but you will be able to see that side fairly easily. And then when the rest of this is painted white, that's going to stand out as well and be pretty cool. A little doorway through there. So, all right. So that turned out really well. I'm really happy with that. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this video for this week. And, continue to work on some other parts of this pod bay. That little lab window right there behind it, I started working on a little bank of TV screens behind that you can see. I also started working on the large tanks behind that little area right there, and I'm going to do the little ones right there as well. So, okay. So this is coming along well. I'm really pleased with that maintenance corridor there. So I want to thank all my subscribers, and I will see you all next week. All right.